The internet is the underlying network that allows people to communicate and collaborate worldwide. It allows us to access websites and use tools like search and email. Many of us think of the internet as a global community, but surprisingly, more than half the people in the world aren't connected. Loon is one attempt to really make the internet available everywhere. Traditional infrastructure involving towers and wires make it difficult to bring it to really remote and rural areas. In looking at ways that we might provide internet access more broadly, we considered things ranging from towers on the ground all the way up to satellites in space. But it seemed like there might be some middle ground, some intermediate altitude where balloons or aircraft could fly.
Our Loon balloons fly in the stratosphere. That's about 20 kilometers or 67,000 feet, and it's above most commercial airspace, about twice as high as most commercial airplanes. NOAA is the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. We use their data actively when planning for our balloons to be able to predict what environments we're going to be flying through. All the data we get on board our Loon balloons is used to make the most accurate predictions we can of where the balloons are going to go, how they're going to land, how they're going to fly, what temperatures they're going to encounter. In Project Loon, we use a lot of the environmental data that we're collecting, both from our different sensors and also the predictive data that we get from NOAA. And we use this to simulate what's going to happen to the balloon over the next 16 days. So this gives us trajectory predictions of where the balloons will fly. It also gives us predictions of what the temperature both outside and inside the balloon will be, and the pressure that we're going to encounter both inside the balloon and outside in the atmosphere.
Computational thinking allows us to gather large sets of data about balloons and their environments, break them down, and then analyze them. And then we can find patterns so that we can make better predictions and build better simulation software and algorithms. An algorithm is a set of instructions that a computer can follow to do something useful. So we use algorithms in order to navigate the balloons in the stratosphere. In order to do that, we collect weather data and also real-world data from the balloon sensors. This helps us understand the environment that the balloon evolves in. One algorithm that we developed is one that evaluates all the possible paths for a balloon given its initial position. So let's say that we have an initial position for the balloon. Based on the weather data for this initial time, the algorithm can figure out which path is optimal for the balloon to take. So another algorithm we've developed is one that corrects the altitude every few minutes so that it stays on track to stay on the right trajectory. For instance, if the algorithm thinks that we should go west and the balloon actually goes east, well, the algorithm is going to overcorrect the altitude so that we stay on track all the time. In our case, creating algorithms is necessary in order to have the impact that we want to achieve. To navigate all these balloons in different parts of the stratosphere all at the same time would be very time-consuming if we had to do it manually.
With every test flight, we continue to gather lots of really exciting data. This helps us not only understand the stratosphere better, but improve our simulations that predict where the balloons are going to fly and how they'll behave under different environmental conditions. That additional accuracy in navigation is what's required to go from flying just one balloon to flying a whole constellation or flock of balloons in formation, equally spaced apart, so that they can provide reliable internet access to the most remote parts of the world.
Thinking computationally means being able to tackle really complex problems and that often seem intimidating and daunting at first, and breaking them down into smaller, more manageable pieces where each piece can be addressed individually, where you can collect data and make models and simulations for each piece and then combine them together to get a good solution to your complex problem.